Hello and welcome to Study with Sudhir, your digital classroom. I hope you are doing well, studying hard. Several students had made the request to give a format as to how a typical good quality answer for the poems should look like. How should they should read? What is the format students should follow? So I just thought I'll just pick up a couple of questions from two poems from one of the pre-board papers that I have. Just to give you an idea about how a well-structured answer should ideally be like. This is from, of course, the first step is obviously for you to identify the poem correctly. That is the first challenge. So if you have done all the poems, that should not ideally be a problem. This one is actually from why the caged bird sings. But a bird that stalks down his narrow cage can seldom see through his bars of rage. I put it down up on the screen. His wings are clipped and his feet are tied. So he opens his throat to sing. Now this is the extract given. So I'll read out a couple of questions from here just for you to get an idea about the kind of questions that can be asked, how there could actually be a googly in this. The first question is, and this is a googly, why does the stanza in the extract begin with but? Okay, now many students jo ki they go with either a kunji kind of an analysis ki sabka summary padh lo poem nahi padho, they will face a problem. Or if they go with explanations from people who just tell you the summary, you know ki is poem mein ye bataya gaya hai, iska arth ye hai, without actually going by a word by word, line by line explanation, which we have given in the all the video analysis of all the poems of Treasure Trove, which are there in the Treasure Trove playlist. Okay. So in this case, unless you have done that, you will not be able to know why this word but is used. But ka istamal kyun kiya gaya hai. So how do you structure an answer like this? Now the first one is to identify the poem, that you have to say right up the beginning. This extract is taken from the poem I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, written by Maya Angelou, who is also a women's activist, civil rights activist, apart from being a poetess. Pehla likh diya, ye do line likh di, break the paragraph, come to the next point, to this question straight away. But intro mein sirf do line, aur kuch likhne ka zarurat nahi, ye likh ke chhod dijiye. Now it is a in the stanza given in the extract, the first line starts with the word but, because in this particular poem the life of a free bird is contrasted with the life of a bird inside a cage, which is why to kind of highlight this contrast, the word but has been used to start this particular stanza. Okay, now the free bird. Now you have to talk about, you have mentioned ki free bird and caged bird ke bare mein ye puri kavita hai. So you need to talk about that. The poetess Maya Angelou talks about the free bird, that the free bird has the entire sky as its jurisdiction, while the caged bird is bound within the cage. The free bird can fly high in the sky, explore unknown territories, while a caged bird's wings are clipped, which is what is mentioned in the stanza also, and its feet are tied. It cannot fly, and all it can do is to describe places it has never seen through its imagination in the form of a song. So it's in order to highlight the contrast between the free bird and the caged bird that the poetess has used the word but to start the stanza, because before this she has talked about the free bird and now she's talking about the caged bird. Okay. Then the other thing is, till the another question is, till where, which is also of 3 marks, till where does the free bird fly? How does it challenge the sun? This is an important aspect. Challenge the sun, and this could actually challenge you as a student. Now the first part is, the free bird can fly far and wide in every direction. It can make the branch of a tree or the ground as a platform to take off and soar high up in the sky, and with the help of the wind, the breeze, it can soar high. And when the free bird locates some fat big worms, it can actually have them for its food. It can swoop on them in order to eat them, and that is in fact shows its ability to take care of itself, in contrast with the caged bird. That also you should mention, just to show that you know about it, in contrast with the caged bird, which has to depend on its master or owner to feed it food. Now the second part of the question, how does it challenge the sun? How does it challenge the sun? The free bird seems to be in synergy with the sun. The sunshine falling on it fills with positivity and happiness. But it's also challenging the sun, because it is the sun which is generally seen as someone which is kind of, has the entire sky as its jurisdiction, because the sun is the what is giving light to the entire sky and the earth by extension. But this bird, by flying up high up in the sky, it's almost challenging the sun. Ki, just like you, I also have the sky as my jurisdiction. I am a free bird, so I can fly anywhere around in the sky. So, in that sense, it is also challenging the sun. That is what the question is asked. Whereas the breeze and the wind, it actually takes on, and the sun's warm feeling also falls on the bird. So, in that sense, it is also providing some kind of a challenge to the sun. So, that is how you need to answer. So, a lot of in-depth and intelligent analysis is what will be expected of you in the answers to questions like this. Abhi ek aur poem dekhte hain. This is from the Patriot. Alack, it was I who leaped at the sun. I've put the lines on the screen. To give it my loving friends to keep, not man could do, have I left undone. And you see harvest what I reap this very day, now a year is run. Okay. Abhi iska, now this is from the poem The Patriot, in which the hero, I mean the person who was kind of, you know, given a lot of warm welcome a year ago, now he's kind of condemned to death. The first question is, how was the speaker welcomed a year ago and why? So, halaki is in lino mein wo bilkul bhi mention nahi kiya gaya hai how he was welcome. So, unless you know the details and can quote a couple of words from those, use a phrase or two, you will not be able to answer, which is why I keep on saying you need to know every line, every word of the poem. So the speaker in the poem is a patriot, okay, who has done something, the poet's name, who has done something good and praiseworthy for the country. He was welcomed a year ago with roses along his path mixed with the sweet smelling flower myrtle. Everyone was in a joyous mood. The church spires were full of flags and people were jostling for space, so much so that, you know, it looked as though the building rooftops were kind of shaking. People were showering flowers on him. So in that sense, it was a very heroic welcome that he received exactly a year ago. Okay, there was loud music was playing and everyone was happy with the Patriot's arrival. And he said that at that time, even if he had asked for the sun, they would have got it for him because they loved him dearly. So that's the kind of welcome that he received a year ago. Okay, then the other another question that let's just pick up from here, just to kind of give an idea. What tells you that the speaker was over ambitious? What was the result? Again, a tricky question. What tells you that the speaker was over ambitious? Now, when the speaker says that he did all those things which anyone else could not do, and he did everything which a man could do, it would seem that he was over ambitious. And he says, alack, it was I who leaped at the sun. Now, that is something which would not seem like every man can do, but he did it. So he wanted to show that he's better than most other people, you know, to the over ambitiousness did him in, because he felt proud, but it resulted in the end of the day in complete hatred from the people for who he did all those things. We are not given details about what had gone wrong for him, but all we know is that in 1 year the circumstances had changed so dramatically, so that now they had condemned him to death in contrast to the welcome that they gave him a year ago as a hero. So he says that he leaped at the sun, which signifies that he tried to do all that it is difficult for the people of his country. So it shows that, you know, there is a phrase which is used, a leap of faith. Not exactly similar, but in this case, he spoke about a leap which is something not possible for every other person. So that is something you need to know to do, which kind of conveys that he is a someone who kind of pushes the envelope. He tries to do something which other men, other people cannot really do. And he does that for the sake of his country. So that is how you need to kind of give answers in detail. It's not the length which matters. It are the keywords which matter. In this particular case, you need to talk about the over ambitiousness, the fact that he's condemned to death, leaping at the sun. These will all be the keywords which will kind of indicate what he needs to do. So you need to keep that in mind. If you're able to do that crisply, giving some analysis, you should be safe as far as the marks is concerned. So that's as far as explanation of this particular, these two poems are concerned. The same formula will apply to every other poem in this particular treasure trove from which you will be asked questions. So I hope it's all very clear. Any doubts, write in the comment section, which I will be more than happy to answer, as I always do. Also, like and share this particular video with your classmates and friends so that more and more students can actually benefit from this. The exams are not many days away. And also, subscribe to Study with Sudhir. That's something which you need to do. Thank you very much for watching.